This one right here is the true definition of a nightmare. So if you make it to the end, I appreciate it. Please like, comment, and subscribe.
That's what we're here to fix. Take care of that. So looky, looky, looky where we are back today. Today we are back at our reverse cycle defrost system. Freezer, well, but this part of the rack isn't reverse cycle defrost. This is for reach-in coolers along the wall. They got a... Look at that. That leak right there. That's what we're here to fix. Take care of that. I wonder if... Yeah, she's a big one. Look at that. Alright. I'm trying to see like a valve off. I can shut this. Valve on liquid line ain't helping me any. Oh, wait, they got a valve on the suction port too. Okay. Yep. All right. I think I can just recover the gas on the suck on the condenser side. Okay. Yeah, you're all cheap. I'm gonna try. I think I could just recover the gas on the condenser side of this whole operation here, this little system, and just recover that. That'll save me a lot of time and a lot of refrigerant. So I'm just gonna make sure. As these coils are shot, I'm just gonna make sure nothing new. There goes some damn reversing valves over there, switching over. This fucking thing. I gotta turn this rack back on. But I'll leave this. I'll turn this one off. Alright, so let's pull a quick vacuum on my recovery tank. I'm gonna reuse the rubber refrigerant sealer. Got it shut. The liquid line valve right here. Looks like that.
Chill and relax
for a little bit.
All right. That's pretty fast. I pulled found out exactly 18 pounds, 18 ounces, nowhere near the 47 pounds that it holds. I'm at exactly zero pretty much. And still got 155 PSI in the system going to the evac. Just going to verify one thing. Good, cool. Alright, so what I'm gonna do before I shut the rat down, my flame will be crazy, is I'm gonna just hit this with a wire brush. Cut it off, put it on the trail. I probably should. But, gonna get this all cleaned up here. And, braise it, pressure test it, do the vacuum, and, charger the heads of my refrigerator back in, and we should be good to go.
Pressure in there. She's holding. I started bugging out because I'm hearing something, but I got it off. And it was kind of quiet for a second. It ended up being a stupid reversing valve over there. Still bypassing gas. I've been swearing I had a leak. Pissed me off. Holding pressure. I sprayed everything down again. I even went over everything over there again. Just because that's why I kept hearing shit. But they're reversing valve. But like I said, everything's good. I went over this a couple times, so. Alright, let's get the vacuum pulled on here. Charge it back up so I can get out of here. I got more work to do. Out of the tank for a receiver and they get the
One thing I noticed the last time I was here also, is that the unit has some issues pumping down when it wants to pump down. So I adjusted the pressure control a little bit. But it looks like the solenoid opened back up. It wanted it to cut off that 20. 10, I'm sorry. It was reaching 5, but it's still about to shut down. This unit just had a compressor change out as well. Not hot gas people, but we reverse cycle people the other way. I was wrong. I thought that it was the reach-ins, but no, this is for the open air delicate.
Fucking cursed. I can't win at this one. So this that here. Can't adjust it. It was set way too low. Wouldn't let you adjust it. I tried to unlock and unlock the keypad and it still didn't work. And then I got the pressure control.
Hey. I signed your paper.
Thank you.
And I'm going to leave it right there on the desk because I got to bring the girls back.
I'll take it.
Okay, baby.
Thank you.
I got to bring the girls back.
All right. So, of course. Then the pressure control outside. It's cutting off at the right pressure, but it's not turning on. It's turning on way too high. Causing these to go up to like 50 degrees before they even turn on, so I gotta change that out too. So let's get this changed out and get outside because the store's closing. No one's in. Set. I'm gonna set this to right now. It works. So I front seated the king valve, rotary lock valve, whatever you want to call it, all the way in.
and then did the same to the suction line valve. So I'm valved off to the system. The only thing I'm getting pressure at, or half pressure, is at the compressor, in the compressor. So I got my hose on there. My hose on the suction line. It's only reading compressor pressure. I got it down to about 5 PSI. So it's gonna allow me to change that nut and tie in my new pressure control without having to pull a vacuum or add any more gas, because I'm never gonna reach atmospheric pressure. So I'm just gonna prep for that. Wherever the hell.
Today's a fucking nightmare, but I got everything running good. Pressures look good. Sight glass is clear. Put in that pressure control. The other one's just there. I'm gonna have to come back in and put in a dual, because that's what's needed. But other than that, man, everything looks alright for now. I appreciate you sticking with me through this nightmare again. But hey, that's what it is sometimes.